Hello, I'm Christine Niles. Today's February 2nd, 2021. Here are your latest Church Militant headlines. Pope Francis met with a cardinal who sympathizes with Joe Biden. Over the weekend, the pontiff met with Chicago's Cardinal Blaise Supich, a notorious leftist. The move comes 10 days after Supich publicly criticized the U.S. bishops for condemning Biden's stance on abortion, homosexuality, and gender ideology. Over in Portugal, bishops are denouncing a euthanasia law. Passed January 29th, the law allows adults to kill themselves if they're terminally ill or suffering unbearable pain. From the bishop's statement, quote, "The law gives the wrong idea that a life marred by pain and suffering does not deserve more protection and becomes a burden," close quote. Similar laws passed in Belgium have led to abuse and child euthanasia. In the U.S., 21 men are accusing a Lincoln Project co-founder of homosexual predation. A Sunday New York Times report on John Weaver reveals accusers were as young as 14, while others say Weaver wanted sex in exchange for money or jobs. The Lincoln Project is claiming ignorance of his conduct, but accusers say they're lying, as victims made their complaints known to them long before the report went public. In Congress, a Christian U.S. senator is denouncing abortion of the disabled. Over the weekend, pro-life caucus chair Steve Daines of Montana called the practice eugenics. Quote, "This is a moral question for our country that is basing life on capacity and potential instead of the dignity the life should have, and that is that all babies, all humans, are created in God's image." And in the media world, an executive is slamming one of his network's programs for blatant bias. Over the weekend, CNN's 40-year vice president of standards and practices, Rick Davis, critiqued the CNN show Reliable Sources with Brian Stelter.
I think you need to strive to have more voices on the show from right of center. Responsible voices from right of center on the show.
Stelter refused to respond to the suggestion, instead choosing to laud Davis's accomplishments as an executive. And in China, more evidence the communist regime was linked to U.S. elections. A recent study by the Crime and Security Research Institute from UK's Cardiff University shows 400 fake anti-Trump accounts associated with the CCP. They promoted violence leading up to the DC Capitol riots and also cast pro-democracy Hong Kong protesters in a bad light. The communist government has always made clear their preferred candidate is China-friendly Biden. I'm Christine Niles. Those are your Church Militant headlines. Please watch The Vortex today, where Michael talks about Church Militant's mission of saving souls. God bless you.